Welcome to Aarhus, Denmark.
The 2018
Hempel Sailing
World Championships.
10 Olympic classes plus kiteboarding. 1,400
sailors. 1,100
boats.
85 nations.
It's gonna be a
great event.
Every 4 years, the 10 Olympic sailing classes come together to hold their world championships in a combined event. It's the biggest regatta in dinghy sailing outside the Olympics. And this time, the festival atmosphere, the blazing sun and the warm welcome of Aarhus meant everyone was looking forward to a fantastic week of competition. Along with the chance to win personal glory with a world title, the sailors also had the chance to qualify their nations for the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games. 40% of the available places were to be decided here on the Bay of Aarhus. This is where the dream of Olympic medals starts to become a reality for the greatest stars in dinghy sailing. A first for a combined sailing world championship also saw kiteboarding join the program to blast over Danish waters and impress the crowds. The laser radial is similar to its bigger brother, but with a shorter mast and reduced sail area. It made its Olympic debut in Beijing in 2008, and it's a highly competitive fleet. 119 entries are here, representing 53 countries, showing just how popular the boat is worldwide. European, world and Olympic champion Dutch star Marit Bouwmeester was here to try to continue her dominance in the fleet.
The size of the sail is the only difference between the laser and the radial. The sail on the women's boat is 19% smaller. The typical crew weight is 66 kilos.
Local laser radial star Anne-Marie Rindom won the World Championships in 2015 and then took the bronze medal in the following year's Olympic Games. Back on home waters, she was looking forward to facing the challenge of once again taking the world title.
I'm trying to do my best, as all the others, I guess. But Aarhus is a difficult place to sail, and it's very shifty, the wind, and it's all unpredictable what's going to happen. So I'm just trying to do my best, and hopefully it will be good. I don't think we can talk about like home advantages, because the wind and the weather is so different. But it's great to be home, and it's great to sleep in your own bed for once for a regatta. And it's not going to happen more in your career, I think. So it's just about enjoying it.
Four years ago, American Paige Raley was in a serious cycling accident that left her doubting if she'd ever sail a boat again. But grit and determination got her through the long road to recovery.
It's been hard. You know, I got really small. I was about 59 kilos. So I've been working really, really hard to get back. It's been pretty much 0 to 60 in a matter of one day. I got back in the boat, 30 knots my first day in the boat. So since then, I've just been full speed ahead. Currently, I'm doing campaign for 2020. It's been going well at the regatta so far, so I'd like to finish this event well. And then we're off to Japan, and I'm really kind of just taking it, you know, step by step. I'm not really looking super far into the future, just, you know, kind of focusing on now.
Every team came to Aarhus knowing that consistency would be the key to a good overall performance. But as the series rolled out, avoiding disappointing races and high accompanying scores seemed impossible. Everyone had at least one big number on their final scoreline. With two races remaining in qualification, America's Paige Raley had muscled her way to the front of the fleet, discarding a 37th place, leaving her with a 16th to carry. Belgium's Emma Plaschaert and Denmark's local hero Anne-Marie Rindholm were both just 1 point behind. Rindholm had discarded a 44th, a further indication of just how easy it was to trip up on the race course. But when it came to the final cut for the medal race, the penultimate day's racing shuffled the pack once again. It was Blachard who now led the field, with Rayleigh dropping to fourth after retiring in the penultimate race. Rindholm had also slipped down the rankings to third after a 33rd in the final race. Meanwhile, Olympic medalist Merit Baumeister had hauled herself up into second. The race for gold would now be between the top two, with six capable of making the podium.
This is how they go into the medal race. The top six can all finish on the podium, but it's Emma Plachard of Belgium who has an 11-point lead from the defending world champion Marit Baumeister of the Netherlands.
Yeah, I'm actually quite excited. It's breezy. I've seen it all week, so I'm excited to get hiking and see what happens. Yeah. But I think my priority is just with the shifts. I think it's very hard to match race. So I think, just get the shifts right, get the hiking right, and then, just stay close to her. Yeah.
Going to be interesting by the looks of it. Offshore wind and a top wind mark right underneath the shore. So I think it will be good for spectators to watch.
Here we go. Six of these 10 sailors then could end this race with a world championship medal. And it's Belgium's Emma Plachard that they have to chase. The laser radial race is underway and it's a clear start for everyone as Plachard, our overall leader, closest to us here at this end of the line. Let's have a look at how they are sitting right now. Maria Erdi of Hungary in the mix near the front of the fleet. Marit Baumeister, Alison Young either side of her. Paige Rayleigh also in the hunt, really close as the fleet makes its way up the first leg of this medal race.
Yeah, there was a 15 degree wind shift to the right after the start, which explains why the boats that are furthest on the right are in the advantage at the moment.
The top four overall, Emma Plachard, Marit Baumeister and Marie Rindom with the red bib. And I don't think those positions have changed at the moment. Sarah Douglas, though, is challenging for bronze right now, the Canadian.
So, Jaya, you can see she's top of screen with Young and Douglas. She sort of had to take a flyer out to the right. She also went out there with the Finnish sailor who had to do the penalty turn. So they went out looking to try and come back into this race. The wind has swung to the right, so they've come back into this race.
As the Briton rounds in first, it's all happening right behind her. Sarah Douglas of Canada will come in second. Erdi, we saw coming in across the fleet from the other side. Baumeister will be round in third. The Swiss is round. Here's Rindom. A round of applause from the fans on the dockside. So it's Young, Douglas of Canada in second, Baumeister in third, Erdi in fourth. Our overall leader, though, look at her there, back in eighth.
Rocking on the Donovan.
There was a penalty turn there.
I'm going to say because she was out by herself, there'd be something to do with the way she was moving in the boat.
But she's done her penalty turn. And you can see she's still out in front. So that gives you a good idea of just how big a gap she developed between herself and the rest of the fleet. Baumeister in second, trying to hunt her down. But she'll also be having an eye behind her, counting the number of boats between herself and Plachard of Belgium. Now let's have a little look at the battle for bronze, because it was a medal being held by Rindom going into this, but Paige Rayleigh of the USA, starting fourth overall, is in the hunt. Third in this race, third overall. The American is looking at bronze right now. Here they are at the final mark. Alison Young, the leader, is round. Maria Erdi, round as well. Now, Anne-Marie Rindom trying to reach that mark in third place, being closed down on by Marit Baumeister. The leaders are heading towards the finish line, and now so is Anne-Marie Rindom. A big cheer goes up from the grandstand here on the dockside. The finish line is in sight, and Rindom is heading for a bronze. Alison Young, world champion 2 years ago, wins the medal race here in Aarhus. Maria Erdi comes in second, and behind them comes the Danish. Anne-Marie Rindom finishes in third, and the bronze medal winner in Rio takes bronze at the World Championships on her home waters. Now, Marit Bouwmeester of the Netherlands. This is the battle for gold, remember. She crosses the line, but Emma Plaskaert is right behind her, the yellow bib of the overnight leader. She holds on to that gold medal place. It's gold for Belgium. Emma Plaskaert claims the first world title for Belgium.
Well, I know Marit is really good at like gaining boats, so I was a little bit afraid that she would jump over me, but yeah, I gave it all I got and I'm so happy to come away with the win. It's really good,
And gold went to this lady, Emma Plaskaert of Belgium. 25-year-old who has been so consistent in really difficult changing conditions throughout the week here in Aarhus. Marit Bouwmeester silver, Anne-Marie Rindom of Denmark bronze. We'll be back in Aarhus shortly at the 2018 Hempel Sailing World Championships for more action from the men's laser event. The Danish city of Aarhus has really welcomed the 2018 Sailing World Championships with open arms and has put on a fantastic show for the sailors and visiting crowds, something that World Sailing President Kim Andersen has certainly noticed.
Everybody I've met has really been very thankful and think that the organizers are doing a great event, and the city of Aarhus is really behind it with all the sponsors, so I can only be very, very happy and very proud to be here. All the way during the planning, you know it's a big event, but then being here and seeing how big it is and how many sailors are really here and how they are filling up the atmosphere here, that's just fantastic. I feel that Aarhus is living up to all the best expectations we can ever had. But having said that, don't get me wrong, but we expected Aarhus to deliver because they've done it so many times before. But again, this is a big event and they're just overshooting again and delivering. So I can only say thank you to Aarhus.
Over 250,000 lasers have been built since their introduction to the sailing world in 1971. They can be found in boat parks across the globe, and there's a staggering 165 entries here to compete for the 2018 world title. Olympic champion Tom Burton from Australia and world champion Pavlos Contides of Cyprus were the two favourites here. But it's a hugely competitive fleet, so it was anyone's guess who would stand on the top step at the end of the week's racing.
When it comes to class rules, the laser is simple. If it wasn't supplied with the original build, the answer is no. Pitting sailor against sailor in simple identical boats has been a winning formula around the world.
For such a strong sailing nation, you might be surprised to hear that there's only ever been one laser world champion from New Zealand, Nicholas Burford, back in 1994. But after some time away from the laser, following a taste of success at Rio 2016 where he took the bronze medal, Sam Meach was back in the fleet to try to be the second Kiwi to win the world title.
After Rio, I wasn't really sure what I was going to do actually, so I took a little bit of time off. And I really miss sailing, so I decided I wanted to come back, and the laser was kind of for me, you know. I just love the racing and the lasers. I started to come back last year, and it was a little bit tricky at the start because you lose it very quickly when you jump out of the boat. But I slowly got better with the results, and the end of last year I felt really, really good. Unfortunately, the Worlds didn't go that well, but hopefully I can redeem myself at this year's Worlds. We've got a really awesome squad at the moment with 5 sailors, so it's a really strong team, and we're all going really well. So we've got a lot of the boys who potentially could finish inside top 10, which is really exciting for the country. There's a long time before the games and a lot can change. I'm just trying to sail the best I can, and I think that's kind of the goal for the team, is to get someone doing well at the Olympics, no matter who it is. If I get the chance to go back to the Olympics, I'll definitely be looking to be higher up on the podium. Sailing's a difficult sport, you know, because there's so many variables, and a little bit of luck does come into play on the day, no matter how well you prepare yourself. So to get another medal would be the ultimate goal.
With more talented sailors than available places in the medal race, qualification in the laser fleet was always going to be tough. Add in some tricky and shifty weather conditions, and the consensus in the fleet was for some erratic results and a high-scoring event. Yet, right from the start, there was one sailor who bucked the trend, New Zealander Sam Meach. Consistency seemed to come naturally, at least to start with, as he took 3 straight wins and a second in the opening races of the Red Fleet. But as the weather threw more curveballs at the fleet and the qualification process turned into Gold Fleet racing, Meach's dominance was challenged. By the eve of the medal race, it was the Cypriot, Pavlos Kontides, that had climbed the leaderboard to head the rankings. Although he was only 4 points ahead of Matt Wern in second, he was 19 points ahead of third-placed Elliot Hansen. While the fight for gold looked like being a match race, the scrap behind would see 4 sailors, including Philip Bull, Sam Meach and Tom Burton, battling to get onto the podium.
This is how the 10 line up, sitting pretty at the top. Pavlos Kontides of Cyprus, who's done enough to guarantee himself a medal. But which colour will it be?
Great breeze, so just keen to go out and have some fun and hopefully win a world championship.
It's the most important event of the year, and now I have even the chance to win the bronze medal.
It's a good bit of breeze we got out there on the medal race course. Should be a really good, exciting spectacle for Aarhus.
Kontides, the Cypriot, and Wern of Australia. They are fighting for gold. 4 others are all in the hunt for medals as well. And the laser medal race is away. 3 medals, 6 sailors in the hunt then, as we see the Norwegian Herman Thomasgaard closest to us. It's a clear start.
Here on the screen, though, they are hanging from the toe strap in the middle of the boat, hanging out and working really hard with the legs, applying pressure on the boat and let the upper body do all the rest of the work to counter the waves and to make sure the cockpit keeps dry.
There you get a good idea of the distance and where they are on the course. Say they're about 2/3 of the way to the first mark. And Matt Wern has managed to get some distance now between himself and Pavlos Kontides. Wern needing to get a boat between him and Kontides to snatch the gold medal from the Cypriot. And at the moment, Kontides is sitting in 8th, Matt Wern in 4th. But the Norwegian is leading the medal race. But let's see what's happening behind. Sam Meach in 2nd as things stand. It's close though with Nick Thompson and Tom Burton all coming into the mark at the same time. See the 4 boats behind Thomasgaard. That's where the battle is really happening right now as the Norwegian heads downwind. Sam Meach round in 2nd. Nick Thompson there. Philip Ball in the mix as well. At this top mark, Matt Wern has got enough advantage on Kontides to go into the gold medal position, and Kontides needs to start moving back up the fleet. He needs to close distance on Wern. 2 boats now between Matt Wern and Pavlos Kontides. So Wern in control of the overall leaderboard, holding on to that gold medal position. We have lead changes going on all the time between the Norwegian and Sam Meech. And at the moment, Sam Meech, the New Zealander, is just edged in front. And there, you can see them right beside each other, cat and mouse. Elliot Hansen of Great Britain has got a penalty for rocking downwind and now has to do a 360 turn. And that is a penalty that's likely to cost him a World Championship medal. Thomas Gard comes to the gate, chooses his mark. But here's the yellow bib of our overnight leader, Pavlos Kontides of Cyprus, who rounds that mark well down the fleet, and he's seeing the gold medal slip from his fingers. What can he do to get back into it?
Yeah, he definitely needs to do something now. But, you know, he won a silver medal in the Olympics in London. He's a reigning world champion. He's very, very talented. So I'm pretty sure that he has all the skills to make it right. But on the other hand, Matt Warren is also in the lead now and will do everything to defend his position.
Back with the front two, Sam Meech and Herman Thomas Gard of Norway. And Philip Bull still consistently sitting there in third place. Jean-Baptiste Bernard's trying to close the gap on Bull. Bernard's out of the reckoning for any medals. But Bull holding on to bronze right now. And as they come up to the top mark already. Now, who's going to come out on top for this medal race at this top mark? It looks like the Norwegian, Herman Thomas Gard and Sam Meech. The duel between them at the front of the fleet continues. And on this leg, it's gone to the Norwegian. Now, there's Matt Wern. Where is Kontides? No boats between them, and that means that Kontides is back in contention. He's got his hands on the gold medal once again. So a disastrous upwind leg, really, for Wern. He lost a lot of places and the advantage over his nearest challengers, Kontides.
Yeah, so if Kontides stays one place behind Wern, he doesn't even have to pass him, then he holds on to the gold. And I think Matt Wern will try everything he can to get one boat in between him and Kontides so he can claim the gold. But I'm pretty sure that Pavlos will hunt him down now and make his life a bit harder.
This is an amazing battle. And you can see the tension on both sailors. You really can.
Bottom mark. The Norwegian is round. Sam Meech in third, Tom Burton in fifth. But what is happening at the back? This is the battle for gold and silver. The Cypriot holding on, staying in touch with the Australian Matt Wern.
Wow, that was the move there and needed to happen. He needed to sort of, Wern almost needed to slow up and then come up and inside the British sailor. It's reached to the finish now. Very hard to make a pass in this angle.
So Herman Thomas Gard crosses the finish line alongside Sam Meech in second place. Philip Bull will take third, a result that will likely secure bronze medal for him. Then comes Tom Burton. Then comes Jean-Baptiste Bernard of France. He's out of the medal contentions as the Frenchman. Nick Thompson across in sixth. But what about the battle for gold? Here comes the Australian Matt Wern. He's over the line. Now, is there anyone between him and Kontides? There is not. Pavlos Kontides of Cyprus bangs the side of his boat. He celebrates, and that came very, very close to a silver medal, but he did enough. He fought back, having dropped down the fleet. Kontides fought back to defend his world title.
sure Aachen is a special place for me. 10 years ago, I won the Youth World title, second time in a row, and now again, the senior title two times in a row. And feelings are amazing, and I cannot say much more.
Confirmed Contides as the gold medal world champion. Matt Wern then had to settle for silver and Philip Bull for bronze. What a spectacular day of racing for the laser class. So join us again in Aarhus at the 2018 Hempel Sailing World Championships for more battles on the water, when it'll be the turn of the fast skiff classes, the men's 49er and women's 49er FX.